The program provides an automatic roof framing feature that quickly frames the roof according to the structural members defined when building the roof. This can be a great way to visually present the project, even though truss framing is commonly used. Let's look at the process to stick frame our bachelor view sample plan. Creating the framing first begins when you build and define the roof. The basics include the pitch, type of framing, overhang, and roof height. In the roof options for control of the eaves, and then the roof structure. In the structure panel, there are options to have the framing auto-generate as your roof changes. A framing reference marker that specifies the starting point for the layout of your framing. You can specify the rafter and lookout spacing, as well as the style for the roof blocking. The roof layer section defines the makeup of the roof components. For the surface, you can see the top layer is standing seam metal roofing, underlayment, and then the sheathing. There is an option to add purlins, insulation, and an air gap. The roof structure has a 2x12 I-joist. There are several types of framing members available and layers for insulation and an air gap. For the roof sizing, you can define the sizes for the various framing members of the roof. Note, for the rafter, it's defined above in the roof's structure layer. Once all of the attributes of the roof are defined, you can frame the roof using the automatic option here, or under the Build Framing menu. First, I'll delete the roof framing under the Edit menu. Under Delete Objects, I'm going to come down and delete the roof framing. Once the framing is removed from the Build Framing menu in the Roof panel, which mirrors the same options from the Roof dialog, there's an automatic Build Framing and a one-time Build option. As I select the one-time Build option, the program generates the roof framing as it has been defined in the roof structure. This is an efficient way to visually display and generate the roof framing. All of the automatic generated framing here can be manually adjusted to your project's needs, such as creating a copy of this rafter. In the 2D framing view, you can manually draw a new rafter. It will come in at the correct elevation and pitch. And you can also create roof blocking. Roofs can be framed individually. In this remodel example, I can frame the new roof by selecting both roof planes. Then, in my lower edit menu, you'll see an option to build the framing for these roofs. You might notice that I used a line style and material for the new construction that differs from the existing construction. In summary, stick framing the roof can be a great way to visually present the project, be used in combination with truss framing, or be used for actual stick framing construction. To learn more, please see our other videos.